How many people here, when lunchtime comes around, no matter what beautiful food is going to be put in front of us by Chef Santi and his team, how many people make a regular daily trip to the salad bar? Oh, I should see more hands than that, right? Should be an everyday trip, right? And it's so easy for us to take for granted what's there because it's there every day. Beautiful array in two long containers of fresh vegetables. Some are in the small containers that you can just grab and nibble even if you're not going to make the salad. Some are already mixed, but a wide assortment of beautiful, colorful, fresh vegetables, many of which come from farms right in our area, and sometimes we even know the location of where they've been grown. Easy for us to take for granted that we can just pick up and eat a carrot, right? So easy, so yummy, so scrumptious, right? Or celery, or cabbage, peppers of all colors, potatoes. Every day they're there. You gotta swallow so I can talk. You want some of my hair? It's really yummy. Well, not everybody is as fortunate as we are to have access to fresh, yummy vegetables. Some people go hungry and barely find food to fill their stomachs, the least of which is fresh vegetables, which are actually fairly expensive. Well, a number of years ago, about 9 or 10 now, there was a third grader at a school not that unlike ours in a small city called Somerville, South Carolina. She was a third grader. She was 9 years old. And one of the projects in class that year was to grow a vegetable. So the teacher, much like we've probably done here, it started with a seed. It was a cabbage seed. And they grew the cabbage seed in the little Dixie cup until it was, you know, a sapling. And then all the students were to take the sapling home and find somewhere in a pot or in a garden in their home where they could grow the cabbage sapling, take care of it, see who could grow the biggest cabbage. Of course, some of them, like goldfish, didn't make it, right? They didn't get the nutrients of the soil. The kid forgot to take care of it. Some of them actually grew fairly well, and it was a contest among the third graders to see who could grow the biggest cabbage. Well, not dissimilar from San Antonio, there are lots of deer that roam around that part of the low country of South Carolina, and they eat things just like they do here. So this particular student figured out that she's going to have to build, as her cabbage was growing pretty well, she wanted to win the contest, right? I'm going to have to build some kind of a fence around my cabbage so that the deer don't come and eat it. So with her dad and her grandfather's help, she built a little cage, and the cabbage grew. And it grew, and it grew. I don't know, I'm going to guess this one is maybe a pound, maybe two. When her cabbage was done growing, it weighed 42 pounds. 42 pounds of cabbage. Now, even if you, cabbage is the main ingredient in coleslaw. Anyone like coleslaw? Yeah, me too, Mr. McCullough. 42 pounds of cabbage would make a lot of coleslaw, more than even the most hungry coleslaw-loving person could eat. So this girl's family didn't know what to do with their 42-pound cabbage, so they decided, hey, there's a soup kitchen nearby where hungry people go to eat. And whatever it is they can serve there, it probably doesn't include fresh vegetables, so let's just go and see if they can use our 42-pound cabbage and use it to feed the people who come through the line that particular day. So she goes, as a 9-year-old, to the soup kitchen with mom and dad, and during the time she's there, as she watches people go through the line and get their meal, and she sees them enjoy some of her cabbage, she thinks about how many people are going to get to enjoy from that one vegetable. What would it be like if a whole garden was grown and cultivated and cared for, and all the food that grew in that garden, all the vegetables that grew in that garden, how many people could that feed? So this young girl decides to go to the headmaster of her school and ask if there's a plot of ground on Blind One's the name of the school, went and asked if there was a place where students might plant a garden and take care of that garden, and the produce that would grow in that garden they would give to this soup kitchen where she had given her 42-pound cabbage. And the answer, of course, was yes. I would love to have a garden here. She encouraged other students to become involved, and it was so successful that this young 9-year-old girl, her parents, finally decided that this should happen in other places. So let's continue this in other locations, in other schools, in other cities, in other states, to engage young people, children, in growing gardens and raising crops that would be donated to hungry people. And the idea caught on. She ultimately started the foundation, a nonprofit organization, still based and operating out of that small city in Low Country, South Carolina. But now, it's grown so big that there are these organizations and these gardens are now operating over 100 of them in 35 states. The goal is to have one in every one of the 50 states within the next couple of years. This young girl now is 18. She's a college freshman. So what started as a little idea when she was a 9-year-old has become now this movement all across the country where children ages 9 to 16 and the adults who support them, in some cases schools, in some cases community groups, are growing crops and sharing the produce, the fruits of their labor, their harvest, with soup kitchens and organizations that feed hungry people in many of those 35 states, soon to be 50. And then eventually, her goal is that this organization, which carries a very appropriate name, will spread to other countries. It all started with one little seed that became a sapling, that became a 42-pound cabbage, that became a garden in her school, and now is happening all across our country. The garden at that school is still running. Last year, it produced 1,100 pounds of produce. That's a lot of vegetables. That's just one garden in one school, 1,100 pounds that came from the Pinewood Garden. And so for her efforts to not take for granted the vegetables that we so easily enjoy and sharing the fruits of the harvest of that first garden and the 100 or so now that are scattered across the country. Today we honor this great young citizen. Her name is Katie Stagnano. Here she is at age 9 with her big 42-pound cabbage. And here she is now as an 18-year-old with a basket that looks much like continue to live into that example. Amen.